Across the country, communities are grappling with the problem of how to reduce youth violence and improve the lives of our young people. The Oakland Unified School District is committed to ensuring that all students learn alternatives to violence by teaching the social skills of empathy, impulse control, emotion management, and problem solving. Learning these particular skills is proven to reduce violence and lead to greater success in school, in work, and in life. The district has chosen two proven curricula, Second Step and Too Good for Violence. The Second Step program has been adopted for all preschool centers and elementary schools and is taught in 5 middle schools. Too Good for Violence is being taught at 16 middle schools.
The school district and the city of Oakland have successfully partnered to both fund and to implement a program called the Second Step curriculum. It's an important partnership. It's clear that where we have seen Second Step implemented well and consistently in schools is where we see good results relative to lower suspensions, increased attendance, and just an overall much better school climate and classroom atmosphere.
There's so much that goes down on the recess yard. And if kids aren't empowered to solve conflicts, to calm themselves down, to be fair, that all drags right back into the classroom. Second Step is part of the plan that really makes it work. And they're able to practice skills that they learn in the classroom with their teacher and with their classmates. They're able to practice them out here on the yard, really reducing definitely suspensions, definitely violence, and then also just those annoying, like tattletaling and gossiping kind of infractions.
Hey, this is Emma. She's the one against the wall. And Emma tried to join a game of keep away at recess, but nobody would pass the ball to her. Try to put yourself in Emma's shoes. How would you feel? Evelyn.
How would they feel, Daniel?
Mad and angry and disappointed.
Empathy is important because some people might be sad, like something happens to the family, and maybe you have been through that. You can tell them, oh, I'm sorry about it, what happened. And maybe that person might feel better and they're all like, okay, then I'm not the only one with this problem. I have people who can support me, who has lived what I'm living.
When the program is taught consistently and promoted school-wide, children will internalize the values and exhibit kind and fair behavior.
Study after study show that there is a strong relationship between children's social skills and academic achievement. Without teaching kids the tools necessary to deal with anger management and impulse control and learn how to be empathic beings, they're not going to do well academically.
In this class, we do a lot of group talks. There are a lot of opportunities in this class to practice listening and learning and how to respect each other, because that's like the main rule in class.
My research demonstrated that not only is Second Step an effective program in helping to reduce violence and aggressive acts at school, but it's also a program that teachers really, really love. Everything that the teacher needs to be able to teach the program is provided in a single kit. There's teacher buy-in, the students buy into it, and then research shows that it is very effective in reducing, over time, aggressive acts.
In my work as a school psychologist with children who get in trouble, so often it's the lack of a plan B. They have one reaction to whatever kind of conflict situation there is. The wonderful thing about Second Step is they help expand the repertoire of solutions and options that children have. It can also be even saving their lives when they realize that not every conflict needs to turn into violence, because they have these problem-solving skills that they have learned in Second Step.
As state and federal funds shrink, the citizens of Oakland have stepped forward to support district violence prevention curricula as part of the city's Measure Y Violence Prevention Initiative. We need continued funding to ensure ongoing staff training, coaching, and materials. To find out how you can help, visit our website at www.ousdviolenceprevention.org.